Hello and welcome to Buckman's Model Mania. Today I will be working on stage 75 of the Volkswagen T1 van. Here are the parts for the that came with stage 75. There's a window here, some very small detail parts. Actually, it looks like this window, if I'm not mistaken, will be able to open, and that's what those detail parts are for. Goes along with the parts that came in at stage 74, which we'll just look at and set aside. Same thing here, stage 75 is finishing the electric parts that we received in stage 73. So let me go ahead and get the book open. I'm gonna flip the van up on its side and we'll go from there. So here's what we're gonna need in the parts from stage 73. I've got the circuit board, I've got the harness with the switch, battery box, this plastic part, which is the shield for the circuit board, the horn, the steering box, the two tabs to hold wires, and then three sets of screws. So let me go ahead and turn the van up on its side again. And it says right here, caution part from issue 73 shown in the picture, electric components should be handled with great care. The solder of the connection circuits are delicate and easily damaged. And that is very true. So let me switch over to that camera. You can see the bottom of the van now. And here are the parts. So first thing it does has me do, let me go ahead and open the screw box here. It's behind the van. First thing it says to do is to take, and by the way, not really impressed with the battery box. I will be replacing this. What I may do is, I'm gonna just replace overall the battery box. The battery box will sit in place. What I'll probably do is this will plug into the circuit board and I will just put another board at the end of these wires to be able to cut down the voltage from whatever power supply, like a 9-volt power supply probably, to a 4.5 volt. Done it before. I've got the boards handy. Well, they're not really handy. I've got them put away here, but they're very easy to put in. So what it has me do is it says to take the switch right here, go ahead and stretch it out. So this switch goes through the battery box from the top side and just make sure, secure the switch, tweeze past the end of the cable through the hole shown until the switch is located in the housing on the other side of the battery box. So it's gonna come up like this. So the battery box cannot be completely replaced because it houses the switch to turn the van on and off. Of course, on the other hand, if I replace the switch or the battery box, I won't need the switch. It says retrieve the chassis, and that this is gonna go in. Oh, this goes onto the chassis, sorry, not the interior. So let me get the chassis and we'll put that in. Okay, so here is the chassis, and actually looking, just reading through the instructions, not realizing that it was the chassis, I was like, how is this gonna work? But now it makes sense, because when I put this on here like this, and you've got a dot here, hole here, two posts here, just make sure the switch goes to the front. That dot is just a positioning dot. And these, it'll all fit in there like that. So the batteries you can get to from the bottom of the van. Put that in there. And then it says, let's see. Secure the battery box using 3 BD screws, which BD, they're going into metal, so I will get the oil out right here. there's the three BD screws. There, like I said, I need the oil because the chassis is metal. As usual, I'm just going to start the screws and then go back and tighten them all down. Also, anybody who's seen me do a few part works will know that I go cross corner between the first and second screw, all the way through all the screws if I can. So there's the third one. Let me put the oil on there, put it in the hole, not break the chassis while I'm doing it. The screw fell over when I started trying to tighten it down. So actually, if I could get it in the hole, there we go. So tightening it down, there's one, and I'll just go reverse order to tighten them down. Two, three. Now the battery box is firmly secure. Place the plastic protector, this part here, for the circuit board on the post located on the left side of the left wheel arc. Then place the board on the protector and in position as shown. Secure with two BD4 screws. So this here is going to go on here like that. And its whole purpose in life is to keep these solder joints from touching any metal. Double check, see how this is supposed to go in here. The two screws are supposed to go to the front like that. And it doesn't actually firmly push it down on there. But I actually like the way they do that. So let me get two BD4 screws, which are over here. And those are gonna go up here in the front. I am not gonna do more than just snug them down most of the way because I don't want to snap the board. The first one's gonna be tricky because I've gotta get three pieces lined up at the same time. So through the board, through the protector, and almost. And I just dropped that screw. So let me grab the other one. We'll do the same thing. Okay, I'm going to do the closer one instead because that way I can actually see a little bit better what I'm doing. Okay, so man, I am going to pause for a minute so I can do this off screen. I will be right back. Okay, so I got it on there. I'm not really pleased with the way they did this, but I've got to deal with it the way it is. You can see from the side here, let me see if I can get a better view on there. Let me do a side view here. You can see how pronounced that is lifted up. Not really happy. I didn't tighten these very tight, but that could lead to a broken circuit board. Fortunately, when they misshipped it, it was delivered to the wrong address. I actually got that package, so I do have a spare board should the worst happen. So what they say to do next is to take the wires. And let me see, what are they doing? Hang on. Okay, once those are in there, pass the battery box kit and cable through the guides and secure with two medium screws or medium tabs. Okay, so they tell you to take these two wires, put them in this channel here. I'm just looking, where is battery and battery switch are right here. And it does actually say to plug them in eventually, so I'm going to go ahead and plug them in now. And they are polarized. They can only go in one way. They say that the plug is the same way. Wow, that's loose on this side. So I wonder. Actually, I think those posts are angled so that the board is like that. So this is going to be the battery switch. I'm going to go ahead and plug it in, being careful not to press too hard down on the board itself. Kind of amazing that that is that loose. Still really loose. Okay, let me tighten the other one too. It's kind of a happy medium between too tight and snapping the board and not tight enough and the board is flopping all over the place. So let me go ahead and plug in plug four, which is the battery. Like I said, the way that this is set up is that a board will fit easily in this space once if I clear it out, and so I'll be able to put power from wall power. And it kind of has you leave it up a little bit. It actually has you doing this after these are in here, but this channel is so narrow. So much different from the channels on the other, on the interior portion that I did before. It's a lot smaller channel than it was on the other, on the interior than it is on here. Really tight fit. Plug is in there. I'm going to pull this up just a hair because I need to be able to get into these plugs later on. Make sure that these wires are on the same side as they are up there. Again, like I mentioned in the last video, it's nice. These are not going to cut wires in half, or they shouldn't. Okay, that is that one. That one, wire's not pinched. There it is. I was looking for that screw and I couldn't find it. I figured I'd find it later when I stepped on it. That was BD04. So that goes on there like that. So those are down, wires are plugged in. On the bottom of the car is where the steering box, the two remaining parts, the steering box and the horn will go. So let me switch cameras real quick. And we will flip the car up on its, actually, I can go back because there's nothing sticking out far enough to be damaged. You get close the oil and get it out of the way. Put this down. So the horn goes over here, and actually there's a screw that goes in there. That is not going to stay on its own. The steering box has a screw on in it as well. I'm just looking. There should be, okay, there's the locating pin. Probably something like that. Let me take a look and see what the what it looks like. Oh, it doesn't really show. There's a locating pin. There is a screw hole. neither of them are going to stay in place. So let me go ahead and flip the car up on its side, switch over to this camera. First one is going to be the horn. The horn is going to go like, let me make sure. Trying to put the horn on backwards. So the horn's going to go on here like that. BP04 screws. BP03s. Oh yeah, BP04s. The most populated screw in the build. I've got a ton of them left over right now. So there's two of the screws. Let me get the screw loaded up first. Otherwise, I'll never get it. Everything together. Come on. I'm looking at it from a really odd angle. So there's the hole right here. Screw goes in, tighten it down. Get this one loaded up and get the steering box back in there where it belongs. This is out of camera, but there's a pin hole. There's a locating pin and this pin hole for the screw tower to go right here. Like this. So those are in there. Now you can see. Here's the steering box. Here's the horn. Go ahead and close this. Put the car back on its wheels. And while I'm at it, I'll bring the interior over and set it on top. Maybe. Yeah, wires and stuff are right now not lining up. Actually, there we go. It's going to push down on there a little bit. Not sure how soon this will actually get mated up. But that is all there is to do in issue 75. Issue 76, I believe we will be putting the rest of the first side door together. I think that could be the problem. I think we definitely. That's why it's not fitting on. The whole car is shifted to the right. Just looking, making sure things are clearing. A speaker's gonna be underneath there. That's actually how it's gonna go on. So we're getting there, and of course I popped the vent pipe off the chassis again like I did in that last time I had the chassis. So that's where we are right now. Car is coming along really nicely. Starting to get body parts. Looking forward to building the body on this. It's going to be a great build with the body. At this point, I'm guessing this was issue 75, so I think I have about 45 issues to go. 45 issues for the body, and I'm sure what they're going to do is have us put this together, put this on here soon. And the body's actually going to get built around it on like most builds where you build the body and then set it on top. Hope you're enjoying this build. I know I am. Like and subscribe. Come on over to Hobby Time Modelers on Facebook and YouTube. See what we're doing. Join us on Facebook. We also have Discord. The link is not in the description, but the link should be on the Facebook page, and on almost every video there should be a link. Come on over there, that way you can join us on the Friday or the Sunday streams. Hope you have a great day tomorrow. Hope you have a great day today. Great afternoon, morning, whatever time you happen to be watching. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and I will see you on the next video.